Slow-moving pohoihoi is generally not a direct danger to human lives, but it is incredibly hot, 2100 degrees Fahrenheit when it first erupts. That heat can burn or destroy nearly everything it encounters. The crust that forms over lava reduces the radiant heat, but many things, such as wooden structures, catch fire before the lava even touches them. Other hazards accompany lava flows as they move through populated areas. Smoke from burning trees is already becoming familiar to residents of Lower Puna as the flows move through the forest. Forest and brush fires are often started by lava. When lava flows encounter roads, burning asphalt creates a plume of black smoke. This smoke, a mix of petroleum particles and gases, irritates eyes and lungs and should be avoided. Houses and buildings may contain numerous chemicals, toxins, and explosives, making it dangerous to stand nearby when they burn. Stay out of the smoke. 1606. If you live downwind, you may want to seal up your house as tightly as possible. When lava travels over vegetated areas, it can ignite methane gas that is built up underground and cause explosions. While most blasts are minor, larger explosions can be hazardous since they can send rocks flying tens of feet. The ground above septic tanks or cesspools is particularly prone to igniting. Gas and propane tanks are also potentially explosive when heated by lava flows. Trees and wooden poles that get surrounded by lava will usually burn through at the base, though they may remain standing for hours or days. When they fall hard, and with little or no warning. Large breakouts of lava may surge forward very quickly and spread in new directions without warning. Vehicles and people have been trapped by these surges when roads were cut off. Sulfur dioxide gas, called VOG, is not a problem at the front of a pohoihoi flow because most of the gas is lost as the lava travels on the surface. When a lava tube is established, however, sulfur gas can leak out of cracks and skylights and become an irritant to people just downwind. The lava flows don't release any hydrogen sulfide gas. Most utilities will be disrupted by lava flows as water, power, and telephone infrastructure is burned. If your home is in Lower Puna, having alternative sources of water, electricity, and cell or satellite service is a good idea. Always assume downed electrical lines represent a fire and shock hazard and avoid them. If the lava flow reaches the ocean, the interaction of the hot lava and seawater will create a plume of steam laced with glass fragments and hydrochloric acid, known as lase or lava haze. Lase is salty and very corrosive. Residents should avoid this plume when it blows on shore and seal windows in homes. The hazards associated with lava flows can change dramatically with time, weather, and flow location. It's important to keep informed.